Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast: historical samples found during the construction works in Trabzon, Western Armenia. 10 mini stadiums to be built in Ninotsminda, Javakh. Posters presenting Shushi as Azerbaijani city at London Underground are being removed. The Embassy of Armenia in UK. EU report on Turkey includes possible tourism sections. The Ganispe waterfall of Western Armenia is under protection. The great philanthropist businessman Galust Gulbenkian was born on this day of 1869. Preliminary work has been suspended as a result of historical samples being found during the construction of a car park in the Pazarkap district of Ortahisar, Trabzon, Western Armenia. The museum will prepare a study report. The prepared report will be submitted to the Department of Territorial Protection. The museum has denied discovering gold in the area. An application was sent to the Ministry of Culture and Tourism for excavations in the area after the historical layers were found. According to the first finds in the excavated area, they belong to the period of the Roman Empire. Excavations in the area, going on for about a month, are currently suspended. According to the report, the Territorial Protection Council will decide whether to carry out large-scale excavations in the area. The municipality of Ninotsminda of Javakh this year has allocated 457,400 laris for the construction of 10 mini stadiums in the city and villages. Tenders for their construction have already been announced. JNews.ge reports, large-scale construction of mini stadiums is starting in Ninotsminda municipality this year. Tenders for the construction of 10 mini stadiums have been announced since March 11. The two mini stadiums will be built in the city and the other 8 in the villages. The deadline for applications is March 23. The municipality has announced 3 tenders for 10 works on the construction of mini stadiums. The Embassy of Armenia in the United Kingdom reports the following. After the formal complaints put forward by the Embassy of Armenia, as well as the UK Armenian community organizations, the offensive posters at the London Underground, displaying Armenian historical and cultural heritage as Azerbaijani, have now been removed from the TFL network. Vice President of the Republican Party of Armenia, Armen Ashotyan, had posted on his Facebook page posters advertising Azerbaijan at the London Underground, presenting Shushi as a center for Azerbaijani culture. The European Union is considering imposing sanctions on Turkey's tourism sector before this week's summit, EU Observer reports. According to the strategic documentation of the EU Diplomatic Service, the alliance will discuss a wide range of sanctions targeting key sectors of the Turkish economy. Other measures discussed include restrictions on giving lands by the European Investment Authority and sanctions on individuals in the energy sector, especially those involved in drilling in the disputed waters of the Mediterranean. Ganispe waterfall in Çatak, Van, Western Armenia, is registered in the list of specially protected areas. The waterfall starts flowing abundantly in late April and decreases in the middle of August. The waterfall is a tourist attraction people often visit, especially during the summer months. The waterfall has gotten its name Ganispe, meaning white waterfall, due to its milky white color, which is formed due to the streams of running water. Armenian businessman and great philanthropist Galus Sarkis Gulbenkian was born on March 23, 1869 in Constantinople. He has had a huge role in the process of making the Middle East oil reserves accessible to Western exploitation. Galus Gulbenkian has chosen the profession of oil expert miner. He received his education in noted European universities and mastered 8 languages. Back in 1860, Galus' father Sarkis Gulbenkian was active in the oil industry, owning several oil companies in the Caucasus, especially in Baku, and represented the Alexander Mantashev International Organization in the Ottoman Empire since 1880. After the genocide of 1915, he got territories in Mesopotamia to shelter refugees. Gulbenkian formed the General Committee on Petroleum during the First World War. He had oil fields in Venezuela, Iran, Iraq, Saudi Arabia, and the United Arab Emirates, and was aware of the legal and illegal entries of the Sultanate and the Persian courts. He had the levers of large oil companies in his hands. He had managed a valuable collection of art, where about 6,000 original samples were included. From 1920 to 1940, he took over the Armenian schools and medical centers in Turkey, Syria, Lebanon, Jordan, and Iraq, and undertook the construction of numerous churches in the Middle East. In 1946, Gulbenkian donated $400,000 to the Madrasa of Holy Echmiadzin. Galus Gulbenkian died on July 20, 1955, at the age of 86 in Lisbon. His body was buried in St. Sarkis Church in London. Now I present you Maral Shisho by Nubar Ensemble. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.